Can't you see it? Can't you see them having fun? Can't you see them having fun? Or can't you see them having fun?
For Tim and Tara?
Yay, Tim and Tara!
They're from Shake Bartenders. So if you need either a bartender or a helper, you know who to call.
Wow. Shake Bartenders.
We just have been thrilled from beginning to end.
Thank you very much.
Thanks to Bill and Lou, who couldn't make it last year, but they made it this year, all the way from Portland, by train.
Thank you. And if I could mention, they were at our wedding. They've been at every anniversary party, except they couldn't make it last year. So it's incredibly special for us that they were able to be here.
You're here. A reminder to please feel free to take home cake and leftovers. We'll pass out to-go boxes. Almost all of you know the routine. For those who don't, just ask somebody else and they'll tell you. Everything's fair game and don't be shy.
Like silverware?
Yes. I want to say just a quick word in lieu of a speech. Cindy and I were reminded very recently how incredibly lucky we are to be able to have family that we choose instead of family that we're born with, or maybe in addition to family we're born with. So all of you are the family we choose, and right now that's especially meaningful to both of us, and we really, really, really are pleased to have you in our lives. So thanks, one and all. Much appreciated.
Yes, if I could mention that, we had a very difficult weekend last weekend with our real family, and to be able to look forward and know that this weekend we're surrounded by people who love us is just unbelievably fabulous.
We do
so
love
thank
you.
Thank you all so much for coming. That was just really, really especially wonderful.
Only some of the family we had trouble with last weekend. Just to clarify. We didn't write them all off. It wasn't that bad, but it really is fabulous. So thank you again. So this year, I'm going to do something different and unusual. I'm going to plagiarize. We've discovered the Frog and Toad series of books. Cindy and I have, thanks to our local neighborhood bookstore. And I read these to Cindy every night at bedtime. And they're absolutely charming and heartwarming and fabulous stories for kids and grown-ups. And I'm going to read Cindy's favorite, which is called Spring. So I'm going to leave it to you to decide which of us is represented by Frog and which of us is represented by Toad, but I don't think you're going to have too much trouble figuring it out. Frog ran up the path to Toad's house. He knocked on the front door. There was no answer. "Toad! Toad!" shouted Frog. "Wake up! It's spring!" "Blah!" said a voice from inside the house. "Toad! Toad!" cried Frog. "The sun is shining. The snow is melting. Wake up!" "I am not here," said the voice. Frog walked into the house. It was dark. All the shutters were closed. "Toad, where are you?" called Frog. "Go away," said the voice from a corner of the room. Toad was lying in bed. He had pulled all the covers over his head. Frog pushed Toad out of bed. He pushed him out of the house and onto the front porch. Toad blinked in the bright sun. "Help," said Toad. "I cannot see anything." "Don't be silly," said Frog. "What you see is the clear, warm light of April. And it means that we can begin a whole new year together, Toad." "Think of it," said Frog. "We will skip through the meadows and run through the woods and swim in the river. In the evenings, we will sit right here on this front porch and count the stars." "You can count them, Frog," said Toad. "I will be too tired. I'm going back to bed." Toad went back into the house. He got into the bed and pulled the covers over his head again. "But Toad," cried Frog, "you will miss all the fun." "Listen, Frog," said Toad, "how long have I been asleep?" "You have been asleep since November," said Frog. "Well then," said Toad, "a little more sleep will not hurt me. Come back again and wake me up at about May 1st. Good night, Frog." "But Toad," said Frog, "I will be lonely until then." Toad did not answer. He had fallen asleep. Frog looked at Toad's calendar. The November page was still on top. Frog tore off the November page. He tore off the December page, and the January page, the February page, and the March page. He came to the April page. Frog tore off the April page, too. Then Frog ran back to Toad's bed. Toad, Toad, wake up! It's May now! What? Said Toad. Can it be May so soon? Yes, said Frog. Look at your calendar. Toad looked at the calendar. The May page was on top. Why, it is May, said Toad as he climbed out of bed. Then he and Frog ran outside to see how the world was looking in the spring.
The end. So this is it. We're just right out of the house. It's spring. Thank you all for being here to celebrate with us.
And a toast to my wife, Cindy. Okay, James, we're going to have our annual waltz now. James is in charge of the music.
Here we go. Oh, we have to clink first.
Yes,
we
do. Everybody has a waltz, not just us. First time. Oh, sweetest. No, everybody waltz.
We're just enjoying watching you guys.
You guys are really good.
Everybody gets to take cake, so there's cake in boxes, so don't leave without taking
it.